Today, we learn how to create a virtual machine in Azure using all the advanced configuration options via the Azure portal. My name is Leon, and I'm here with the awesome Jerry Steele, who is going to show us how to do that. So, how you doing, Jerry?
So far, so good. Thanks, Leon. So we're here today talking about virtual machines, and what we're going to do is just take a tour through some of the options. Azure's got a ton of configuration options for virtual machines to really support whatever workload you need to do. If you're doing a small hobby website, you can create a virtual machine that's for that. If you're moving a massive enterprise organization with lots of different applications, we've got virtual machines that do that. Let's kind of go in the middle today, and we'll just sort of take a tour of the things that you could possibly do. I'm going to come to the Azure portal, and I'm going to say create a resource. And I'm just going to create an Ubuntu server. Now, the way that we structure the create process in the portal is we have a number of tabs here that sort of walk you through different sets of configuration options. On this first tab, we've got basics. That's sort of like the minimum amount of information you need to create a virtual machine. We ask you things like what subscription, what resource group you want to be in, the name of the virtual machine, where in the world do you want to put it? Do you want to put it in Australia? Do you want to put it in the United States somewhere? So let's do that very quickly. So I'm going to put in a virtual machine name. I'm going to leave it right there in East US. You get to choose what image you want. So that's basically what operating system you want to use. We came in with Ubuntu. If I wanted to change my mind and say Windows, we can do that. And of course, we have the Azure Marketplace, which has over 4,000 different virtual machine images, some from Microsoft that are first party, some from third party publishers that come in and publish images that you can then consume however you need. Even if you want to create your own image, you can configure a virtual machine just like you like it. You can provision that VM here.
Oh, that's very cool. Yeah. So basically, once I have it in the state that I want, I can reproduce it.
Absolutely, easily. Absolutely. Yep. So let's go ahead and finish this configuration. I'm going to put in a username. This is Linux, so it needs an SSH key. That's it. I could be done pretty much doing this virtual machine. I could hit review and create, and it would just give us a ton of defaults. Let's look at some of what those defaults are and how to adjust them. So we'll go back up here and look at some of these different tabs. The first one is disks, and that gives us the opportunity to configure any data disks that I might want to have for this virtual machine, as well as what's the level of service of those disks. Do you want them to be, do you want to pay a little bit more and have very fast read and write speeds? Do you want to have, do you want to save some money and, have, maybe smaller size or things like that? We're going to add a data disk to this virtual machine and give you the option to say, what level of service do you want for that virtual machine? On our networking tab, you have some options to basically configure some of the connectivity options for your virtual machine. Every virtual machine in Azure we put into a virtual network, and so you can decide which virtual network you want it to be in. We create one by default if you want, but of course you can pick one for whatever application you've got running. You can decide, do you need to have a public IP address for this virtual machine or not? What kind of connectivity do you want? Do you want to open ports to this virtual machine? To have access to it, maybe you want to be able to enable SSH access, and this is going to be a web server. But of course, you can be very detailed about, I want to have very specific IP addresses connecting to this virtual machine, only over these certain ports. We give you the power to configure all those things.
And one of the nice things you mentioned that you can use a network that exists or you can create a new one, and that creation is part of this process, right?
That's right. And that can be very important when you want to control who all can access this this virtual machine or maybe a set of virtual machines. You put all these virtual machines in a network, they can talk to each other, and then at the network level you can decide only traffic from my enterprise can connect to that network, or my personal IP address here in this studio can connect to that IP, but no one else can. And so it gives you all those kinds of controls. Great. Next thing we ask you to look at, is some sort of management and operations kinds of controls for your virtual machine. So that includes, how do you want to monitor this thing? Do you want to turn on boot diagnostics? Do you want to, store detailed logs on the virtual machine? Do you want this thing to shut down every night at 7 p.m. so you can save some money after you go home? Do you want to automatically enable backup on the virtual machine? So we give you some options for that to sort of help you manage and run the virtual machine. And then finally, we have a section here on sort of like we call guest configuration. Once this thing is provisioned, how do you want to actually, do you want to maybe run some custom scripts to complete provisioning this virtual machine and just how you like? So you have a couple of different ways of doing that, particularly with Linux virtual machines. We have virtual machine extensions, which are basically small bits of programs or code that you can sort of have run right after your virtual machine is provisioned. So if you want to install, say, Chef or Puppet to do some of your configuration systems, or if you just want to run a custom script, as soon as this thing is configured, you want to run a custom script, you can do that here. Since this is a Linux virtual machine and it supports Cloud Init, which is a standard cloud provisioning tool, you can copy and paste your Cloud Init script right in there, and it's going to go ahead and run that code right after the VM is provisioned. And then finally, we have a section here on tags, which allows you to decide, basically give it a set of key value pairs, just, you know, basically, they're tags. It's labels that I can put on this virtual machine. And where we find a lot of people using that is, you know, maybe I want to say that, you know, the owner of this virtual machine is Jerry Steele, and maybe the cost center for this virtual machine, you know, and I would put it a certain number in there. And that helps you, you know, with your organization. It may help you with your internal billing, your chargeback system, just like that. And you can decide, do I want those tags to be applied just to the virtual machine or everything that was created as part of this package?
And the nice thing of these tags is that also they go all the way through billing, right? So then you get your bill, you can discriminate.
Absolutely. Very easy then to say, okay, I want to filter out all the cost centers with this number and send it to that team.
Absolutely. That's fantastic.
Yeah, send them the bill. Great. And finally, we hit review and create. And it's going to go through and make sure that all those options that we made sense to the system. It will give you a nice summary here of all of the thing that you're about to provision. Great. So then we'll go ahead and hit create. And so that's going to go away and think about it for a minute and configure that virtual machine. So when that goes, we're going to start to show you basically a pretty real or near-time view of all the provisioning process. So people want to know how's it going? Is it going well? Is anything breaking? And so this view here gives you an opportunity to sort of track all the resources that are created as part of provisioning your virtual machine. And you can see the operational details to make sure everything's working. And if for some reason something does go wrong, it gives you a nice error message that you can help to triage, was it Azure's fault? Was it your fault? What can be done in order to address that problem?
But even in the case where everything goes right, one of the nice things, which is most of the times, one of the nice things that you get here is that you have full control and you're always in control and informed of what's going on with your provisioning.
Absolutely.
Which is a highlight, I think.
Yeah. So great. So like I said, Azure's got a ton of different configuration options for really whatever kind of workload you're trying to do. I know people here at Azure love to talk about that and help with that. And so come to the portal, try it out, ask questions, and we'll get you going.
Thank you very much, Jerry. That was great.
Thank you.
And thanks, every one of you, for watching. Please try these features in the Azure portal and let us know what you think. Leave us a comment in this video, follow us on Twitter, and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thank you very much.